Hello, what's up, good people? It's me again, Festus Kyalo, and welcome to my YouTube channel. Now, Australia is a great place and destination for a lot of tourists, for students who are coming for studies or for any other activity, you know, that people would love to come and enjoy. But there are some things that you need to be aware of as you visit or as you plan to come to Australia. I know this is common to anyone who is already living here in Australia. And although I know I don't have like the exhaustive list of what I'm going to talk about, whatever, you know, I've come across is the things that I was actually not aware of. So we're going to talk about the things that you should not do in Australia. Please don't do these things in Australia. It might be applicable to where you come from, like where I came from. Most of the things were like normal, but coming here, some things you do and it's like, oh, that's not Australian. So don't do these things when you come to Australia. So let's get started. Number one. Don't bargain for prices. Honestly, don't bargain for prices. You know, in my country, if you go especially to a private shop and, you know, the owner tells you the price, you know, the first thing goes in the mind, this thing, I'm being told a higher price for me to bargain so that we meet on somewhere. It's different from Australia. When you find a price is set, you don't bargain, you just pay. So please don't go bargaining, oh, you know, $50, please, can you make it 40? No, don't do that in Australia. Number two, don't forget to wave when a car or a vehicle stops and it gives you away. Please don't forget to wave, and you know, like it's you are appreciating. I know some people may go like, oh no, it's my right, you know, for you to stop, for me to pass. Yeah, it's your right, but in Australian culture, you know, they tend like, you know, to wave even when you are meeting another vehicle and one vehicle stops to give you way to pass. You know, like drivers, they always like, you know, wave each other as a sign of like, it's a sign of like, thank you, we appreciate, thank you for, you know, accommodating me, something like that. So don't forget to wave. Number three, don't joke with the Australian sun. It can be dangerous. It can harm you. Please, if you're being told put on the sunscreen, please put on sunscreen, because it can be extreme. It can, you know, affect your health. So don't take it for granted, you know, don't go out around during the summer around, you know, 1 or 2 to bask in the sun. There is no, honestly, no vitamin D at that time. The sun can be extreme, even can be as dangerous as from 8 a.m. So don't joke with it, with this sun. Number four, please don't swim anyhow. Make sure you follow the signs and the instructions. Some areas can be dangerous, can be prone to sharks. And yes, people are being attacked by sharks. So don't fail to follow the instructions and stay within the safe areas where, in case of anything, the lifesavers can, you know, save you and can reach you with the ease. So don't take it for granted. Remain within the allowable areas when you go to swim. Number five, and this one I struggled with it for some time when I came to Australia, because I was so used to it from where I come from. No handshake unless you know this person very well and it's someone who, you know, whom you have been, you know, doing handshake. So the common greeting in Australia is, hi, how are you doing? With no handshake, you know, people just talk, people just, you know, say hi, how are you? Or where I come from, you know, people can greet one another for like 10 times within a day. But here it's different. Every time I meet someone, I was like, hey, how are you? And it's like, okay, all right. So I kind of struggled for some time before it, you know, I got streamlined to this way of greetings. Number six, and I know some people might argue that this is common, but it's not that very common. Don't forget to say thank you when someone does something to you, for example, gives you a seat or gives you a way, or you are served in an hotel or at a cashier. Don't forget to say thank you. It's very Australian that, you know, if you don't say thank you, people tend to see like you being rude. And I know some cultures, it's not a must to say thank you when you are served. You know, you just like, yeah, I've paid, I've done all this and that. But always, always in Australia, please say, you know, always remember to say thank you. Thank you, you know, thank you. It's very common here. You know, even when you alight from the bus, you know, when you arrive where you're going, you always say thank you to the driver. So it's very common. Welcome to Australia. Number seven, don't take anything too personal. Sometimes in our conversation, you know, Australians are like, you know, talking, and sometimes they may end up probably swearing or saying a word that might not be nicer to you. Sometimes they don't necessarily mean that. It's just a way of talking. So don't take anything personal, like, oh, that person was talking and was like swearing and abusing. No, don't take it too personal. Australians are known to be friendly and good people. Number eight, please don't laugh when someone, you know, talking under shrubs or pronounces the word wrongly or is struggling to say something probably in English. Although Australia is an English-speaking country, it's not everybody who speaks English. So there's a lot of cultures in Australia, and people are patient with one another just to, you know, to make the point. If you don't understand, you know, please, you know, say, please, could you repeat that one? Don't laugh. Don't show some disrespect at all. That is really, really, it would be not Australian, to be honest. And so, yeah, please don't make a fan out of someone because probably they don't know English or they don't speak well. Number nine, and mostly this applies to workplace, please work within your job description. Don't go an extra mile to do things that you are not supposed to do. If anything goes bad, even if you are trying to help or trying to be good, things will be bad on you. You'll be screwed because you do not work within your job description. So please work within your job description. Follow what your contract says, because when things go bad, no one will want to know, even if you had good intention to help. So thank you so much, guys, for listening to this video. I know I've left so many other things that I might not be aware. I'm still learning. So please, if you have, you know, met some of these things or you know something I've left, please hide down there in the comment section, and I really appreciate and thank you so much for your time, and I'll see you again in my next video. See ya.